Welcome to Timeline Travel. In this lecture series, we will make time travels to significant cities in order to discover architectural histories of several prominent civilizations. In other words, buildings of historic cities will be our guide that will narrate the history with the sentences of architecture. Evolution of styles, variations in patronage, or changes in locations of buildings will give us lots of hints about a country's or a city's architectural past. In this particular course, we will visit Byzantine Constantinople with the help of buildings in the empire's capital. By focusing on some of the significant buildings of the city, we will be able to trace the history of Byzantine architecture from the 4th to the 15th century as we walk around Byzantine Constantinople. We will focus on certain monuments, but of course, not every building, by picking only the most convenient ones that will help us to understand the evolution and significance of Byzantine architecture. We will start our journey in the first lecture by going back to the time of the city's founder, Constantine the Great. This powerful Roman emperor decided to move his capital to the east after defeating his rivals and establishing himself as the sole ruler of the empire. He chose the old Greek colony Byzantium and turned this tiny settlement into his new capital by naming it after himself as Constantinople. City walls, fora, churches, water structures and palaces rapidly emerged here, and we will trace the city's first 2 centuries in this first lecture to understand the foundations and roots of Byzantine architecture, which was no different than the Roman architecture at the beginning. Then, in the second lecture, we will visit Constantinople during the reign of Justinian the Great. This period, also known as the Golden Age of the Byzantines, while its territories extended as much as it did in the glorious days of the Roman Empire, also resulted in an immense building campaign in the capital. The most renowned buildings of the Byzantine architecture were built in this period, including churches of Saint Sergius and Bagus, Hagia Irini, and never surpassed Hagia Sophia. Actually, these iconic structures were the reflections of the power of Emperor Justinian and Empress Theodora. Following the reign of Justinian, the empire and the building activities in the capital experienced a decline. The invasions of Persians, Arabs, Bulgars, Goths, and several other enemies in the 7th and 8th centuries unsettled the Byzantines. Then, Orthodoxy experienced a turbulent period called the Iconoclasm, when the churches were stripped of their impressive mosaics and icons. This religious conflict lasted from early 8th till the 9th century, but once the icons were re-established, a rebirth in Byzantine culture was at the door. Therefore, in the third lecture, we will explore this new period called Middle Byzantine architecture, which fits with the needs and limited resources of the time. During the successive Macedonian, Doukas, and Komnenos dynasties, Byzantine Empire went through relatively better times, regained some of the lost territories, and its architecture flourished again, creating brand new plan type for churches called Crescent Square. Finally, in the fourth lecture, we will witness the last transformation in Constantinople's architectural history. After the Byzantine Empire's capital was captured and sacked by the Latin between 1204 and 1261, Byzantine emperors hardly re-established their power in the ruined capital. However, late Byzantine architecture, extended from 1261 until 1453, gave few examples, either with smaller churches or extensions to existing ones, but they were rich in decorative elements, mosaics, and frescoes. Actually, the last works of Byzantine artists, such as the frescoes of Kore Church, were signaling the approaching Renaissance. You may now review the course content in more detail and discover the buildings to be traced in each lecture by seeing the course outline or by downloading course syllabus. You can learn more about Byzantine architecture by studying Late Ancient and Byzantine Architecture in Ravenna course available on Timeline Travel e-learning platform. Do not hesitate to use Timeline Travel whenever you need it. Now, get ready and enjoy Timeline Travel.